So sometimes I have something to say on a topic that's maybe not worth a whole 10 to 20 minute episode, or that necessitates a turnaround time that isn't a whole 30 days like all my other videos. Also, one of the primary complaints I get from viewers is that I don't make enough content. And in an attempt to solve both problems, I present Errant Signal Blips, which will be shorter videos, or videos with lower production values, i.e. fewer slides and edits, in an effort to say more stuff without having everything I ever do be a full-on formal video essay. Don't worry, the fancier long-form stuff isn't going anywhere. And to inaugurate this series of small videos, we'll cover a service that is supposed to help small games, Valve's Greenlight. The general idea is that Valve, with their virtual monopoly on digital PC distribution, are flooded with game requests, so many that they can't adequately vet all of them. So they've decided to crowdsource quality control by letting users vote on which titles they'd like to see released on Steam. This seems like a pretty natural win-win from their perspective. Valve get to offload the work of reviewing hundreds or even thousands of games to their audience. They also get to improve their rep with developers, who will no longer get vague emails rejecting their game weeks after their initial submission. Instead, they get a concrete measure of how likely it is the game will be picked up for publishing, and have a clear path to increasing those odds. Valve also get to engage their audience and make crowdsourcing their store's stock a participatory act. And hey, as a bonus, they get market research on emerging indie titles or genre trends. From their perspective, everyone wins! And the thing is, this would be a really progressive move if they had done this even 4 or 5 years ago. I mean, can you imagine? Giving anyone who comes along with a game more or less the possibility of being published. It'd be anarchy, right? Well, the thing is, in the past 5 years, we have had a platform like that come along. And it's a platform so successful, it's effectively the birthplace of Angry Birds, Fruit Ninja, and Cut the Rope. The App Store. Where, as long as you're not a news application reporting on unmanned drone strikes, or a game criticizing Apple's own policies, you too can release your game. Now, don't get me wrong, Apple's platform is walled garden bullshit next to, say, PCs as a platform, and I'm sure I'll get around to a full episode on how proprietary closed systems are inherently harmful to creative works, even those as quote-unquote open as Apple's. But the point remains, Apple has perhaps the most open, closed platform in the history of gaming. For $99 and a few weeks of turnaround time, you can get your game published. I could get my game published. My coworker Jim could get his game published. For $100 on Steam, all you get is a bar that you can potentially fill if you get enough likes, and then maybe Valve will agree to publish your game. So one has to ask, why is the platform most accessible to indie devs not primarily a game platform? More to the point, why have Greenlight at all? Why do we need to have a little meter that developers need to fill by grinding upvotes from across the interwebs? Why not just let anyone who submits a game that passes basic cert through? Well, for one, hardware. It's pretty easy to see if a game functions as expected on the 10 or so flavors of the iPad, iPhone, and iPod Touch currently on the market. On the PC, it's arguably far more difficult. And then there's discoverability. What happens when instead of 4 or 5 games a week, Steam releases dozens of games a day? New titles would be buried, and 90% of it would be awful. I mean, we can't let everyone through and have the myriad of problems faced by the App Store, or eBay, or Cafe Press, or the Amazon store where you can sell your own stuff, or iTunes, or print-on-demand places like CreateSpace, or in other words, just about any enterprise in the history of the internet more interested in publishing content than curating a library for selfish reasons. Look, we live in the age of digital distribution. Content takes up no shelf space, costs next to nothing to distribute, and there are countless ways to monetize it. There's no reason to limit your stock unless you're more interested in maintaining a slot on your store as an exclusive and attractive thing instead of offering content from everyone. I mean, look at YouTube. Yes, it produces a mountain of shit every year, but it also allows independent content creators like myself, or Game Grumps, or even the first episodes of Extra Credits or Zero Punctuation to come into existence. These are shows that arguably exist only because there were no barriers to entry to their original publication. And even though there are a million stupid cat videos or aimless home movies posted on YouTube every day, Google has invested in their infrastructure enough that the cream rises to the top. Now picture a world where YouTube creators have to spend $100 to get in line between 2,000 other guys, and earn enough upvotes ahead of time to get the right to post. 90% of the crap on YouTube might not exist, but neither would countless other video series you've grown to love. Greenlight was never about opening up Valve's platform. It's about outsourcing all of the hard work to you, the audience. But because their crowdsourcing solution is slightly democratic in nature, because it's partially open even by a fraction of an inch, it brings to the fore all the problems with a closed system. Why does Dynamite Jack get on the service, but not Slender? Why is Octodad begging for upvotes while Offspring Fling sits comfortably in my library? Why can I readily buy 30 Flights of Loving, but not any of Radiant Games' awesome work? The line between a game published on Steam and not published on Steam is capricious and entirely up to the whims of an entity that doesn't have developers' best interests at heart. And when the path to getting published was anonymous and vague, that really wasn't questioned. But now there are these rules to getting published that don't really make a lot of sense and are clearly designed to shut people out more than welcome them in. And that's what's got people talking. And, I mean, that's really the source of controversy here. Greenlight shows that the Emperor has no clothes. It unveils how arbitrary and unfair closed systems are, and it shows that Valve are more interested in quote-unquote curating a library than in helping sell as many games from as many developers as possible. If they wanted indie games on Steam, they'd open up their platform. If they wanted to ensure everyone had a voice and a distribution network for their games, they'd open up their platform. If they had any interest in furthering the medium, of encouraging minority voices in games, in promoting new and exciting mechanics or visual aesthetics, or in taking bold creative risks with titles that might not otherwise be published, they'd open up their platform. Again, it's not this hard to get apps on the App Store, songs onto iTunes, or a design onto Cafe Press. You don't need tens of thousands of upvotes to put old junk for sale on eBay or videos onto YouTube. These problems of discoverability, of a flood of content, of mountains of low-quality work hiding a few genuine treasures, these are solved problems if Valve would take the time to implement them. Instead, they decided to hold a beauty pageant where we judge games based on screenshots and a few paragraphs of text. It's a reality show where the world gets to come together and vote on a few winners and tell the rest of the contestants, sorry, we're just not interested in even having the opportunity to buy your game. And all the while, it's happening under a banner of progress and fairness, which is perhaps the most insulting thing of all. There are a bunch of other topics I'd love to cover. How there's a lot of privileged white-collar dudes acting like $100 isn't a big deal. How beautiful it is that Dejobon Games and other indie devs rush to support others by loaning them the money to submit. And how utterly crushing it is to see so many gamers reject into meme games based on the quality of screenshots alone. Not to mention the fact that how Valve has already censored at least one erotic title from the Greenlight service for being too provocative underscores their lack of commitment to games as an expressive medium. But this is already too long, and each of those warrants a proper discussion in its own right. So I guess my parting words on the subject will be this. People aren't mad at Greenlight, they're mad at a system where Greenlight needs to exist to begin with. Steam is a powerful, popular platform with potential for doing great good. People are mad at the wasted potential.